You can start.
I'm Kathy Hoffman from Cambridge, and in addition to being one of the defendants today, I also am the person who did the nonviolence training for those hundreds who risked arrest over that campaign and part of sustaining that. And mostly what I wanted to add was my reason for being there, and what I brought into the courtroom is the shoulders that we stand on, particularly the shoulders that we stand on beginning in the location of where we're standing, which is earth that was walked on by Native peoples and Wampanoag people right here long before they were taken out, and acknowledging that if those peoples who are still with us today and active, but if their rule of law, which was about being in relation to the ecosystem, prevailed today, we wouldn't be where we are. But we also stand on the shoulders of a long tradition of civil disobedience, and that's a movement that I've been part of for racial and social and economic and environmental justice for decades. And my reason for being a part of this movement in West Roxbury was, unlike much of the civil disobedience that I've participated in, it was always of a symbolic nature, trying to bring attention to the harms of our government and other countries, disarmament here, issues about weapons. And this was an issue to actually not just symbolically oppose a pipeline and fossil fuels, but concretely and practically to actually step into the trenches. As has been mentioned, we stand on the shoulders of this community of West Roxbury. Like they said about Rosa Parks, oh, how could she have just sat down on that bus? I just can't believe it. I wouldn't be able to have that courage. Well, she had been training for 6 weeks, and she had been part of the NAACP for years before she sat down on that bus. And similarly, our actions of getting into the trenches stood on the 2 years of every single day people in West Roxbury standing on the corner saying, this has got to stop. So that was really powerful. And, you know, many people were processed, and there was just this few of us who decided to pursue the trial at Tim and others' real urging to do that. And it was a really powerful choice that complemented the other choices that people made, because it was actually through this trial and bringing Spectra into court, which they have avoided any, you know, and for the first 3 appearances in court, they weren't even there until the judge asked for discovery about this question of safety. And then this man popped up and said, oh, well, Spectra doesn't do business in Massachusetts.
What?
Yeah. And it was, maybe Algonquin does business, but not Spectra. Well, could we find someone who represents Algonquin also? Oh, well, I represent also Algonquin. It's like, of course you do, because it's all the same. But as he, week after week and court appearance after court appearance, tried to deflect and not give us the information, and then it was like, no, I've turned it over 5,000 pages. It was through that process that in court one day he said, there is no safety plan. It was confirmed. There is no safety plan. And he said, you know, we met with the first responders and they were fine with it. And the judge at that point, who was so fed up, turned to him and said, then why is the city appealing? And so part of, I think, her willingness to give us this full day in court, and she could have just let us have the civil infractions, you know, which is kind of nothing. But she dismissed the civil infractions, allowing the necessity defense. And I believe that that process of our court appearances over all this time and persistence and exposing Spectra for the corporate violations and the corporate greed that they are exerting was a piece of that. So I just feel so proud to be part of this community and to feel as though, even though there weren't 5 days, as Tim said, in about an hour and a half, the whole system was not only put on trial for the suffering that's being created by gas, but also the brilliance and the beauty of this community of resistors and protectors who are all across the country in so many different ways saying, not only will we say no to what is going on, but we are saying yes to this earth and to one another for common security.